Hey guys, Momo Guru back with Devlog video number 34 for Astrox Imperium, and today's date is September 26, 2018. Alright, so in the past few videos you've been following that I've been working on the mission script and the storyline kind of quest scripting system. I've made some serious progress with that. I've got about 35 different commands in there, and I still have maybe another dozen or so that I want to implement, but I'm sure I'm gonna come up with some new ones that I want to put in later on. And with that, I needed to develop some kind of editor that would allow me to edit that scripting system, and I now have that in place, so I'm gonna kind of show that off a little bit in this video. So let me jump into the mod tools. And you'll notice here in the mod tools that there are like screenshots, static images back there. And what the mod tools is doing is just grabbing random screenshots that the player creates, and it goes in the screenshots folder. So it's just grabbing random ones out of there and kind of cycling through them. All right, so what I've been doing is kind of building out the different editors that I want to put in the mod tools. And obviously this isn't all of them. I have maybe about three or four other ones that I want to implement. I have a few that some of you may have seen in other videos where I'm messing around with a ship editor and a map editor and a skybox editor. So I want to kind of take the best elements of those and kind of redesign them to make them extremely usable and user-friendly. And once I do that, I'm going to link those up in here. Right now, I've created two new editors. One is the scripting editor, and the other one's a station editor, and I'll go ahead and show you those real quick. All right, so the scripting editor is pretty straightforward. What it does is it loads up every file in the scripting folder, and then once you click a file, it then opens up all the commands of that file, and then it gives you a visual representation of how those commands are connected and the options that are displayed and the different choices and things that are happening. So you can see some of these commands are color-coded. For example, the option command. So the first thing that's happening is it's loading up a text event that chains over to event number two, and then it loads up event number two, which is a show image event. It's showing a tutorial UI camera image. And then after you click to the next one, it hides that image and chains to event number 10, which is an option. And that option is going to number 100 or number 120, which then breaks apart right here. And it goes down to here, then you get provided another option, and that time it's giving you three options. One of them is a checked statistic. So what a check stat is doing is, you know, looking at a statistic ID, and if the ID is true, it goes one area. If it's false, it goes to the other area. So it gives you the ability to kind of, you know, check against lots of different things. I've got check stats. I've got check ship stats. I've got checking faction ratings, checking different player variables. So for example, like a check player var is going to allow you to look at the player's level, his XP, how much he needs to the next level, how many credits he has, how many skill points he has, how much time he's played, how many missions he can currently hold. So it's allowing you to check various different statistics of the player. But anyway, I don't know if I added that, did I? Yeah, so let me delete that. All right, so what's happening here is as these different events go through the interaction or the dialogue box that you're interacting with, you know, when you're chatting with an NPC or any other interacting with other objects, because the scripting elements are going to be available to be attached to any object. So you're not necessarily going to have to be talking to a person. You could be interacting with an item, you know, where it's giving you options like inspect this item further, or, you know, abandon this item, or disarm this bomb, or attempt to disarm, you know, some kind of booby trap or something. So it'll have lots of different uses. All right, so some of the commands that I have in here right now are things like, you know, text events, where it's just displaying some text. Options that'll let you go from anywhere from two to three different options. You can warp to a sector, you can move moves a player to another position. You can adjust credits and level, ship stats, factions. You can adjust skill levels, XP and skill points. You can show images and hide images. You can buy an item, a skill, a ship stat, a faction, a skill level. You can reset the NPC chat timer. So basically when, you know, the NPC, when you're done chatting with something, or that there's some kind of timer involved, that it's not going to let you just continually, you know, talk to him and have the same conversation over and over. You know, it's going to say, we've had this conversation, so go away. I'm not going to talk to you for another 30 minutes or however long you specify. NPC attack, that's going to make the NPC become aggressive and start attacking you, or retreat, run to the nearest station. You can get an item or get a skill. You can set value and check value are very important. Those are what you're doing. You're using those commands to, you know, determine whether or not you've done something already. You know, so if I go and talk to this guy and he tells me to, you know, go rescue his buddy, you know, and then I rescue his buddy, it's going to set value, letting that NPC know that I've rescued that buddy, so that when I talk to him again, it does a check value to say, hey, did you already do this whole quest? Oh, you already did? Well, just jump over here to this other text event where you say, hey, man, I really appreciate what you did for me. So it kind of changes how that works. All right. You know, most of these are pretty straightforward. Checking cargo to see if you have a particular item. You can spawn NPCs and raiders and crates and resources and various different things like that. So basically, it's pretty straightforward. And you'll notice that there's two different columns here. And what that is that, you know, you have the ability to label these different, you know, events. You can label them the same thing, kind of keep them in clusters or groups, or you can label them so that, you know, just at a glance, you'll know exactly what's happening. Like, you know, welcome text, and then pop up an image, and then hide that image, and then give the player an option to do this or not. And, you know, so that just reading these different boxes right here, you can see what they say. But you'll notice that there's a special one that says start. And that start one lets the game engine know that that is the beginning of a string of commands. So go ahead and separate those, and that's what's happening here. I've got two different strings, and that's really useful when you have particular scripting files that contain multiple different conversations. So, you know, you don't have to separate an entire conversation or interaction with an object or whatever just into one file. You could have, you know, all interactions with that object in one file. So there could be six different parts to a quest with a particular NPC or with an object or a station or a structure. And as you progress through those quests, you know, those check values and set values are telling the initial interaction where to go, and it jumps to whatever it's supposed to, you know, saying, okay, this is where I have to go. I need to, you know, he's already done three steps of this five-part quest, so now I need to start displaying text four and start a whole new chain. And by having those start values, it kind of makes it easy for those chains to be separated, and then you can view them easily. Another thing is good for interactions where an entire file is being used to randomly interact with NPCs. So you can see in the NPC good text file that there are multiple different commands. Now, most of them are just single little text commands, but I'm starting to build out different interactions to where you're gonna have options so that when you go and cold call an NPC and he has good standing with your faction, then, you know, these are the things that they can say. And you can build out as many as you want. And I'm keeping those all in separate files. So we have, you know, a file for all the nice things, a file for all the neutral things, and then a file for all the bad things, which, you know, some of those interactions can lead to altercation in combat. All right, that pretty much sums up the scripting editor. It's pretty straightforward. You know, these little icons up here just let you create new scripting files and then let you create commands to go in those files. And what's great is the commands have little helpers and little explanation telling you exactly what, you know, what is what. And when you create new ones, it kind of fills in the gaps for you and makes it a little bit easier. All right, so let's jump out of there. And now we will jump into the station editor. Now, the station editor is very straightforward, as most of these editors are. This one is allowing you to edit all the information in a particular station. So you can see here in Biomate University, that is in sector 0 and it's station 0, so you know the file name is telling you its location. You have all of the station services right here, so you can toggle those on and off as you see fit, and then you can change all of these different variables and little bits of information. You can change the exterior seed and interior seed, which is going to affect the way the station is displayed and rendered out through the procedural generation, and you know, even down to the color and the image that station is going to be associated with. But more importantly, down here we have separated the market items, the university skills, the ship hangar, and the mercenaries for hire. And this is great because it just lets you, you know, jump right in and edit each little bit of information. I can change, you know, quantity items for different items that are available in that particular station. And then even on top of that, change what items are available. I can add new items by referencing the item database and saying, you know, ID number this with quantity of that with a price modifier of this, and then those items can be added to the station. I'm probably going to build that out a little bit more and give you some kind of drop down where you can scroll through, you know, the 1,000 or so items that are in the game. But for now, you're just going to have to make references with the item database and the ID number that you're going to put in there. Same thing with the university skills, does the exact same thing. Ship hangar does the exact same thing. And the ship hangars are probably a little bit smaller. There won't be more than, you know, a couple hundred ships, so maybe I can put a little drop down for that. Same thing with the mercenaries. So you're getting in there, you're adjusting their level, their modifier on their payroll value, and then what ship exactly, what is the ship file that is associated with that mercenary. Pretty straightforward, as you can see, and it's really easy to bounce back and forth, you know, for reference and comparison. And you know, as you make changes, you can save them right here, and then the changes that you make down here are giving you little, you know, saves right there. Pretty straightforward. I am going to be porting over the ship editor, and the map editor is going to be a combination of the Skybox editor and the current map editor, with a few tweaks and changes to add a lot more functionality and usability, especially when it comes to, you know, designing out the ships and the maps for that matter. The item editor is just the item database, which is going to let you go through and kind of line everything up and point to the particular image and make sure that you have things in the right folders and stuff like that. The module editor is pretty much the map editor with a little bit of a tweak that's more specific for modules. And then I have a few generators that are already built that I'm going to pop in over here. They'll let you do things like generate items and skills and stations automatically. I'm not sure if I'm going to try to tuck those into the station editor themselves, because some of the generators apply to maps, some of them apply to stations, some of them apply to structures. So the generators can do various different things, and as I've been building them out, or the functionality for them, which is getting more tied into the sandbox mode of the game, which is much more similar to the original Astrox, where you have the ability to pick a bunch of, you know, options and play with a bunch of sliders and then try to conquer the universe that you've created. So I may be playing around with that a little bit. But anyway, hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you click the like button. And if you're new here, make sure you subscribe. And I will be back in about a week or so with some more information about the mission and scripting stuff. And I'm going to end this video with just a little bit of visual things that I've been playing with. I made some tweaks to some of the UI stuff so that I could get the UI really, really small. It's kind of, I guess it's good if you have like larger monitors and you want to get a much smaller UI. So I played around with that a little bit, and my last save still has that. I've been also playing around with props and building out different things for the maps. I got all the collision detection in there for that. So you can see I've got some different types of debris out here. And then over here I have a billboard. And if you can see, everything's kind of in this cloud of stuff. So I've been playing around with different cloud fields and fog fields, just trying to build out some different prop elements that I can use to, you know, spruce up these maps as I go through and start to develop different areas. Anyway, I think that's pretty much it. There are a few little tweaks and stuff that I did in the stations, but nothing major. I can save that for another video. All right, guys, hopefully you enjoy this. Like I said, if you enjoyed it, hit the like button and subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you guys in about a week. All right, guys, Momoguru signing out.